Just remember, Spartans, the easiest and most efficient way to tackle the Tyrolean Traverse or rope traverse is to treat it like an upside down crawl. We're working along the underside of the rope with the coordinated action of opposite hand and foot movements will make quick work of this obstacle. Although in some instances it may seem easier to simply hook your feet on and drag them along the rope, you really want to avoid doing this for two main reasons. The first reason is, by dragging your feet along by only using your arms will generate a lot of friction. This makes those arms work way harder than they should, much like trying to drag a heavy anchor behind you, burning out the biceps and shoulders and fatiguing the grip dramatically. Couple this with potentially having to go into the fortress, the rope climb or the monkey bars straight after, as it happens with some races, and you'll have no strength left to complete these obstacles. The second reason to avoid dragging your feet is also due to friction, being the heat created by friction. Because your legs are hooked onto the rope statically, the weight of your body being dragged along will generate considerable amounts of heat, potentially causing some nasty burns and abrasions or burning holes in those compression tights. My advice? Stick to your basic upside down crawl, working your way hand and foot along the underside of the rope. Also, using some long socks or obstacle course racing shin guards will minimise any discomfort that you may have when working your way along the rope. Stick to this method and the Tyrolean Traverse will become easier and way less taxing, allowing you to conserve more energy and those arms for the rest of the race.